Hey everyone, it's Scott RC from Visualize Me blog. Today I'm just going to continue on with my lifecycle manager parts that I've been doing, and this one is something that I've been meaning to do for a long time. Finally put my finger out to do it, and that's to extend or add to an existing Brownsfield deployment. So here we have my deployment, Brownsfield, that we imported in the previous sections, and I want to add to it. So I want to manage the environment. And this is something I haven't done, so we'll both go through this and learn together, and we can add a product. Now, I've only got one product to add, which is great. And need, join the VMware experience, sure. Actually, let's leave that ticked. Now, it's a new install, version 1.5.1, small, because that's all I want. We could have HA and large with HA and all the rest of it. Should just do. We just do a small. We'll tick that to say that's what we want. And I'm guessing. View details. Okay, well, it just takes us to that. And we go create environment. Now. Cluster IPs. Okay, cool. So I've only got one, and then maybe later we could extend on the existing one if that's why it lets us, or if it allows us to create HA again once we've deployed non-HA, I don't know. But okay, we've got integrated load balancer. We want to continue with that. I'm going to make it here is Log Insight. IP address. Now, I actually don't have an IP address, but let's go to my trusty info blocks, which should have it. Yep. Now, if it wasn't for this, I'd be really lost in my lab. Let's see. Let's choose one of these. Let's go 232. That'll do. So 10.0.0.232. And what I'll also do. I don't have it installed. That's all right. So what I'll do is I'll also go to my domain control and actually create the fkitty in there. So our new A record, the realized login site, and P address will be 10.0.0.232 at host. Awesome. That's done. And now we have components. So master will do the realize log insight 0 1. I don't like putting master in anything because tomorrow it could not be the master. And then we give that an IP address. So look, let's just pick the next one, which is 231. And I'll also add that to DNS as well. cool. That's done. And if we add components, what does that? Okay, worker nodes. No worries. That's done. Advanced settings. What does that let us do? Oh, okay, let us pick cluster name and storage. Now I've only got one cluster. Storage, vSAN data store. Yeah, okay. Network. Okay, we can select which network is going to go on to. Email. Admin user. Gateway, domain. Next. Alright, so let's read through this. We can go. Enable telemetry, true, DNS servers, thin provisioning, admin email me, DNS, yep. Yeah. Pre validate, great. We can download configuration for later use. So I'll save that. And then we hit submit. Now, hopefully, that'll go in and we can go here, in progress. Let's see what it's going to do. It's going to add the license, deploy clustering. Oh, it's got some. Oh, yeah, cool. Awesome. All right, let's see if this works its way through and successful. If so, awesome. Okay, it's deploying the master node now. Sure. Yep, deploying OVF template, awesome. Okay, so that looks to have completed, which is good. And yep, it's done there. Let's look at an environment. Cool, there's LogInsight there now, which is good. And we can see it's under one environment, which is good. It's just showing the separate requests there. And that's the environment. So LogInsight, awesome. And view details. All right. So have a look at the IP. Yep, that's fine for load balancer. Let's actually load it up, make sure it works. Yep, Well, log in. Awesome. So, yep, we can configure vCenter. I think it might be something I should do. Yeah. Yeah, let's see what we can do. Add components first. Okay, we can add a worker. Fine. Add two requests. Yep. Might as well add vCenter in here while I'm here. Got my service account. That's all right. I'll just use one I know anyway. That's all right. Yep. Configure the host, test connection. And we're got it, cool. I don't know why I clicked that, but awesome. All right, they'll install the agents on the host, set up logging, which is good. Now hopefully it shouldn't complain about no persistent log storage. Yeah, cool. Done. So just one thing, I did notice that here we are missing log insight on the front thing. Now I'm sure it'll just take a little while for it to come through. The same thing happened when updating the environments or upgrading in one of my previous videos. But yeah, log insight isn't shown there. That's all right. It'd be good if it showed up straight away, but I'm pretty positive that will come back. And that's it. So look, it did everything that it's meant to do, which is great. And we can now access the marketplace. LogInsight has its own marketplace anyway, but we can, just like the previous video using the marketplace, we can download and install and it all works fine. So that's it. Have a good one. Cheers, mate.